going to get started today. We have a whole body workout. We'll start with a warm-up, and then we'll go over all the movements that we'll be performing during our circuit, and we'll come back together for some static stretching to cool down. So we're going to start with our warm-up. So I'm going to have everyone get on their feet. And we're going to start with some jump rope. Stay light on the feet, nice and tall. Faking our jump rope, or you can do in calf raises, coming up onto those toes, lowering down. It's kind of hard to see. Okay. I have to stand pretty far back. Let me know if you have any issues hearing me. Awesome work, keep it up. Lighten the toes. Now we're gonna transition into some windmills. So our feet are gonna be wider than shoulder width apart. Arms out into a T. We're gonna exhale, hinging forward. Bring our opposite hand to opposite foot. Good control to the bottom. Feeling that stretch on the back of our legs, into our lower back, sides of our torso, our obliques. Inhale to the top, exhale as we hinge forward. Great work, everyone, keep it up. Mm-hmm. Get a few more in there. Awesome job. From here, we're going to bring our arms back to our sides. We're going to transition to jogging in place. I always feel like I'm marching. More, you can march as well. As long as your movements get that core temperature up. Maybe get a little sweat going. Great work, everyone. Keep it up. Awesome work. About 15 more seconds. Stay with me. Great work, everyone. Awesome. Let's slowly come to a stop. We're going to bring our arms into a T, and let's do some small arm circles forward. We're starting small, good control. And then we can work to get progressively bigger. Still going nice and slow. Let's bring our arms back into that T, stopping our circle, and let's draw our circles in the opposite direction. Arm circles going backwards, starting slow. We're progressively getting a little bit bigger. Let's bring our arms back to meet at our sides. So again, today we have a full body workout. We have four movements. We're gonna be going through those four movements in order five times for a total of 20 minutes. Like we've done before, we're gonna be doing 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off, before moving on to that next movement. So first we're gonna be doing windmill planks. So we can either be on our toes or on our knees, making sure we're keeping that nice long body. Our arms are gonna be extended, shoulders over the hands. We are going to alternate using our bottom arm for base support below. We're gonna reach up towards the sky with one arm, good control to the bottom, and repeat. Back and forth. We're pivoting onto the sides of our feet if we're on our toes with each arm reach. And if we're on our knees, really just focus on opening up to each side. Again, we're alternating for that 40 seconds. Next, we'll be doing bent over reverse fly. So we're gonna be standing for this movement. We are going to have soft knees below our hips. We're gonna have that long spine. We're hinged forward, arms are extended in the front. We're gonna draw our arms back, pinching between the shoulder blades. Good control. Moving in a range of motion that's in line with our chest. So good control here. We're engaging the core throughout that movement. If you have light weights and you wanna be doing reverse flies with the weights, that will work as well. Next, we'll be doing a V-sit hold. We have a few different variations for this movement. We can either have our feet planted, slight lean back, engaging the core to keep that chest up. We can be balancing on the sit bone. We can be holding behind our legs. We can be just balancing on our sit bone, or we can extend the legs to really focus on stability during this position. Last movement is going to be on the ground as well. It's going to be a glute bridge hold. So we're going to be laying on the ground, feet planted, knees towards the ceiling, and we are going to engage our glutes, keep our hips nice and high. You can either remain stationary or add repetitions for that 40 seconds, as long as that we are controlling the movement. And if we're holding, we're keeping those hips nice and high throughout that 40 seconds. Do we have any questions? Awesome, let's start in our position for windmills. Either on your toes or on your knees. We'll start in 3, 2, 1, go. We're opening up, good control to each side. Engaging the core. Great work, everyone, keep it up. Awesome work, you guys. Either on the knees or on the toes, focusing on that controlled reach up. Really think about opening the chest as you reach towards the sky. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. A few more seconds. And recover. 20 seconds off before we move into our bent over reverse flies.
I have to chain this on.
Okay. We'll be on our feet, reverse flies in 3, 2, 1, go. Good control, pitching between the shoulder blades. Awesome work, everyone. Awesome work, we're engaging the core here. We're gazing wherever it feels natural, not tensing the neck. Soft knees, lower hips, that's halfway, great job. Awesome work, everyone, stay with me. We're taking a pause at the top when those arms are drawn back. And recover. Next, we'll be getting on the floor for our V-sit hold. About 13 seconds. Four, three, two, one. Remember, a few different variations here. Either feet on the ground, holding behind the legs, or working those extended legs for this time. Try to maintain that stability or engaging the core, staying nice and long. Mm-hmm. Great work, everyone, halfway. Awesome job, 12 seconds. We'll take you over there. Great work, keep breathing, everyone. A few more breaths, we got it. And recover. Next, we'll have that glute bridge hold or glute bridge with repetitions, whatever you feel comfortable doing. We're going 12 seconds. Four, three, two, one. Keep those hips nice and high, engaging our hamstrings and glutes and our core. Knees stacked over our heels. Continuing to breathe. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. Awesome work. Keep breathing. Remember, if you want to add those reps, you can. Otherwise, holding works just fine. 15 seconds left. Awesome work, everyone. We got it. Stay with us. And recover. That's round 1 of 5. We'll get back into our plank position for our windmill planks in about 10 seconds. Four, three, two, one, go. you want to hold just an extended arm plank, that works as well. As long as we're moving or holding for that 40 seconds. Great work. Keep it up. Keep it up. Great job, everyone. 15 seconds left. Good control as we shift from arm to arm. Great job. Great job. And recover. We'll be on our feet for our reverse flies here in about 15 seconds. Great job, everyone. We'll start in 4, 3, 2, 1, go. We're exhaling as we draw those arms from underneath us. Pausing at the top, pinching between the shoulder blades. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. That's halfway. Try to avoid that rounded back. Stay nice and long. Awesome work. Keep it up. Keep it up. Exhale, extend. Inhale, lower those arms down. Get a few more reps in there. Keep it up. And recover. We have our V-sit hold next. We'll be on the grounder mat, doing whatever variation feels best for you. We have about 10 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, V-sit. Great work, everyone. Keep it up. Engaging that core, staying nice and long. Chest up towards the ceiling. Halfway. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep breathing. Hold your breath. If you have to take a break, try to get up as soon as possible. 12 seconds. Awesome work, everyone. Belly button in towards the spine. Try to maintain your stability. You're doing great. And recover. We have our glute bridge next before moving into round 3 of 5. How's everyone doing? Thumbs up.
So you're getting a little shaky on that.
We'll have our glute bridge here in 3, 2, 1, go. Exhale, extend those hips up. Knees over feet. Awesome work. Really think about keeping those hips nice and high. You're either remaining stationary, adding those pulses or reps in. You're doing great. Keep breathing. Halfway. Awesome work, everyone. Yeah. 10 seconds. Keep it up. Keep it up. Awesome work, everyone. We got it. A few more seconds. Keep it up. Stay with us. And recover. That was round 2. We'll get back into our plank position. Feel free to grab water as needed. You guys are doing great. We're starting round 3. About 10 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. We're in our plank, our windmills. Good control as we transition. Belly button to the spine.
We can get straight up now. This? Oh, good. Okay. Oh, okay, it's
no. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. Stay with me. You're doing great. Awesome work. We're engaging that core, belly button in. 10 seconds left. We got it. And recover. We'll be on our feet for reverse flies. Keep it up, everyone. About 10 seconds. How are we doing? Four, three, to one of those soft knees, hinging forward, exhaling to the top, inhale lower. Our arms are almost fully extended. Really think about pinching between the shoulder blades as you draw your arms out from underneath you. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. That's halfway. Try to keep your gaze down towards the ground. We don't need it to tense the neck. Awesome work. 10 seconds left. We got it. Good control here. Awesome work, everyone. And recover. We have our V-sit hold next. About 15 seconds. We'll start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. It's definitely hard as some of it is. Awesome work, you guys. Keep it up. Awesome work, you guys. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep breathing. Engage that core, belly button in. Chest up towards the sky. Awesome work, you guys. We got it. For whatever variation feels best for you, as long as you're maintaining that lean back. Belly button in. Chest up. And recover. Our glute bridge next. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. About 10 seconds. We have our knees over our heels. We'll start in 4, 3, 2, 1. Hips nice and high. Awesome job, everyone. Keep it up. Keep breathing. We're drawing that belly button in. You know, hips as high as possible. Arms wherever they're comfortable. We got it. Stay with us. About 13 seconds left. Let's go. Let's go. Awesome work. We're almost there. Keep it up. Keep it up. And recover. We're starting round 4 or 5. We'll get back into our plank position here. About 15 seconds. Awesome work, everyone. We'll start in 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Awesome work, good control, we got it. You're on the toes, you're on the knees, keep it up. Really open your chest to each side. Extend our arm up. Using our bottom arm as our kickstand or base support below. Inhale, we open our chest. Exhale to lower that hand back down. We're going to the opposite side. Keep it up. 2 more seconds. And recover. 15 seconds before we go into our stand, our bent over reverse flies. 10 seconds. We'll start in 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Remember to keep that spine nice and long. I know we're getting tired. We're doing great. Really focus on form. Our knees are soft below. Inhale to lower. Exhale as we draw those arms up. We're gazing down, don't tense the neck. Belly button to spine, we got it, keep it up. Great work, everyone, 15 seconds left, we got it. Okay, engage that core, belly button in. Keep it up, keep it up. And recover. I saw. We'll have our V-sit hold. Or boat. Yogi's call it. We're in the boat. 10 seconds. Awesome work, everyone. We'll start in 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Whatever variation feels best for you, belly button in. We're maintaining that lean back. Keep it up, keep it up. Awesome work, everyone. We got it. Halfway, let's go. Keep breathing. Chest up. Belly button in. Let's go. We got it. Mind over matter. 10 seconds. Keep breathing. Awesome work, you guys. Keep it up. Keep it up. And recover. We'll transition into our glute bridge. Hold. About 10 seconds. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hips nice and high. You got it. When it comes to that last round, you're doing awesome. Really focus on your form. Continue to breathe. We got it. Keep it up. Keep it up. Awesome work. That's halfway. Keep those hips nice and high. Engaging the core, glutes. Keep breathing. We got it. Let's go. 10 seconds left. Keep it up. Keep it up. Great work, everyone. And recover. Last time through. About 15 seconds. We'll go back to that plank position. We'll start in 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Awesome work, everyone. Keep it up. Last time through. Great job. Good controls. We shift from arm to arm. Inhale to lower. Excuse me. Inhale to open. Exhale to lower as you transition arms. Keep those hips down. Everything's in line. I know we're getting tired. You're doing awesome. Keep it up. Keep it up. 15 seconds left. Let's go. Great work, everyone. We got it. Looking good. Looking strong. Let's get a few more reps in there. And recover. We'll get on our feet for our last set of reverse flies. Keep it up, everyone. We got it. 12 seconds. Four, three, two, one. Exhale, we draw those arms back. Inhale to lower, long spine, good control. Awesome work, you guys, keep it up. Awesome job, we got it. We're pitching between those shoulder blades. Belly button in towards the spine. Keep it up, that's halfway. Awesome work, everyone, we got it. Last time through. 10 seconds. Keep it up. Keep it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And recover. Last V-sit or boat pose. Ten seconds. Awesome work, you guys. 4, 3, 2, 1. Last time here, maintain that lean back. Belly button in, chest open, let's go. Awesome work, you guys. Do whatever variation feels best. Last time here. Let's try to challenge ourselves. Halfway, awesome work. Great job, great job. We focus on maintaining good form. We have 10 seconds left. We got it. A few more breaths. Keep it up. Keep it up. And recover. Our glute bridge. And we'll take about a minute to get our heart rate back down. We'll finish with some static stretching. About 12 seconds left. We'll get into our final glute bridge here in 3, 2, One, nice and high. Great job, you guys. You got it. Keep breathing. We're so close. You can see the finish line. Great work, you guys. It's halfway. Keep breathing. Keep those hips nice and high. We're doing awesome. Mind over matter. 15 seconds left. The higher the hips, the better. Keep breathing. Engage that core. We're doing awesome. A few seconds left. And recover. Awesome work, you guys. Again, we'll take about a minute. Feel free to grab some water, walk around. Let's work to get that heart rate back down. Then we'll come together for some static stretching. How is everyone feeling? Got some thumbs up. Got some thumbs up. Awesome. We'll take about 20 more seconds. You guys did great. So we're going to stretch on the ground today. I think we usually do that. So let's work to extend our legs in front of us. Our knees are soft, but our legs are fully extended, feet flexed. Let's exhale, hinging forward, reaching for the toes. You'll feel this down the back of your legs into the small of your back, your lower back. Nothing should be painful, mild discomfort at worst. Let's inhale as we draw our chest away from our knees. From here, we're going to bring the soles of our feet together in front of us, knees away from our midline. You may feel it here through the inside of your thighs into your hips. If you need to exhale, hinge a little bit further, feel free. Again, it should feel good. From here, we can bring our chest away from our feet, bring our knees back in towards our midline. From here, we are going to extend our right leg out about 45 degrees. And we can bend our left leg so that the sole of our foot is towards the inside of our thigh. We are going to turn our chest towards our extended leg, hinging forward, really isolating the side here. You should feel it into your lower back. Again, nothing painful, should feel good. Foot either flexed or pointed. Just make sure that you're doing the same thing on each side. Continue to breathe. Let's inhale as we draw our chest away from our knee. Let's extend our left leg out again, 45 degrees. Bend that right leg in. We're going to take the exhale once again, hinging towards our extended leg. Make sure we're keeping your either foot flexed or extended like it was on the opposite side. Keep breathing. You guys are doing great. Yeah. Let's inhale, drawing our chest away from our knee. We're going to stay in a seated position, whatever that looks like for you, as long as we're able to maintain that tall posture. from here, let's take our hands to meet near the small of our back, clasping our fingers. Let's exhale as we extend our arms, opening our chest and shoulders. You can either continue to gaze forward or inhale, letting your head fall back to stretch the front of your neck. Again, whatever feels best for you tonight. Continue to breathe. Let's inhale as we lower our arms down and then release them from behind us. We're gonna take a few spinal twists here. Let's take our right hand to the outside of our left knee. Place our back hand nice and close. Remember, opening our chest to the left, shifting our gaze in this direction. And if you'd like, you can work to look over that back shoulder. We're staying nice and tall, feeling the stretch down the sides of our torso, our obliques, into the sides of our upper back. And in through our neck. Let's inhale as we turn our chest to face forward once again. This time, let's take our left hand to the outside of our right knee. Back hand nice and close, same thing. Staying nice and tall. Shifting our gaze either to the right or over that back shoulder. Let's inhale, turning our chest back to face forward. Awesome work today, you guys. I'd like to thank you all for continuously coming to this class. It's great to be working with familiar faces as well as new individuals. I hope everyone had a good time and enjoys the rest of their evening. Thank you.